All right, welcome back guys. In front of me, three device already installed Windows 11 Pro ARM 64. Can it come close to the performance of the handheld PC? All right, let's begin. LG GX V50s, Poco X3 Pro. The only device got sound GX. V50s, no Wi-Fi. And Poco X3 Pro, no audio. Well, let's power it on. GX V50s. And Poco X3 Pro. And GPD Win 4. Why? Of course, Windows start first. It is a PC. Well, Poco X3 Pro, the only device the gyro working. B50s. AMOLED display and IPS display. Well, not bad, the angle, the viewing angle, if you compare to the AMOLED, sure, AMOLED the best. Wait, what happened to my GX? The controller, this one D8 BSP D8. BSP D6 and JK02. This one got 3 mod: Direct, Xbox, and Switch. Same as the other two. Why my GX not booting? It's shutting down. All right. All three already. Let me set the controller. All right, we start with the Poco X3 Pro. First game. Oh. loading time, it depends. Snapdragon 860. 860 GSX and BBTS SD855. Which is better performance? Audio. Timestamp in the description, I will give it, or in a comment. This game not yet perfect. Maybe 10 FPS. Setting. Graphic at 720p. All low, 720p, all low. Kazama.
Get ready for the next battle.
Oi, 100+ FPS. But in game, maybe 3 FPS. This is the loading time. Really, really slow. This is an offline game. The online only on the handheld PC. Since the license game not booting on the device. Oi, 13 FPS. Wow. This is slow motion. Poco X Pro. Alright, second device, LG GATX. This one also got the sound, so no need to use the external speaker. Oh, crash. Poco X3 Pro crash. Oh, too small. Hold on, let me do the setting. Oh, no need. Already. Full volume already. Too small, but never mind. Why? Why it's not respond the controller? That's funny. AMOLED display. Why my controller not respond? Wrong setting, is it? Yeah, hold on. Now it's okay. The tiny. Never mind. Display setting. Full screen or borderless, it's the same. 720p. That's up. The sound though tiny, but at least it got sound. Wow, this one is slow. The controller are all connected via Bluetooth. Ah, really slow.
Get ready for the next battle.
Poco X3 around 14, 13, 15 FPS maximum, but GATX. Don't Crash Bandicoot. The loading time really slow. All the game are copied to the internal storage. 12 FPS, more or less FPS. But the graphic on this see the graphic better than the Poco X4 FPS. FPS a bit low maybe, but most important graphics. This FPS can be adjusted. Never mind, more or less. Still slow motion also. Right. B50S. On idle, that Poco X3 crash. Something wrong. Let it idle there. This is B50S. Amoled DS IPS. Okay. Only problem with this 50S, no Wi-Fi. This controller got a RGB. So graphic same 720p full screen facing off. Same setting. After this it tests Tomb Raider, Rise of the Tomb Raider, that one. You will see the difference of the CPU performance. A lot of difference. Rising. One thing, have to be careful, temperature. GRX 5042. Don't know yet. Just starting.
Get ready for the next battle.
Ouais. Where am I? Really, really sad. Sure, I'm a bit lower. 8, 9, 10. But the graphic need, the graphic are perfect, no glitch, only the performance. The GSX 15 now. Drop again. Actually, these two are using the same display, GSX and B50S. Same type of display. Well, performance more or less. Right. Next game. How to exit? Okay. I'm good. Alright, let's see the handheld PC. How many watt the TDP? 8 watt only. Set at 8 watt. 8 watt. Let's try 12 watt. Right, 12 watt. Because the gyro, see. I'm using the gyro. This is the license game. At the moment, it's free on Steam. This one is the at 720p or so, this one. I think so. Let me see the setting. Okay. Start it. Thank you. run a lot of mod story arcade player BS player player BS CPU. Okay. Only 4 player, okay. So could the cook this second? 4 players.
Get ready for the next battle.
Should be loading like this faster. That's loading. I'm on the right. Should be playing like this. Why? Why? KO. Still far away compared to the PC. Maybe if we can get a better driver, maybe we can get close. Maybe 20% performance. Alright. Next game. Tomb Raider. This one I should play one by one. We start with the Poco X3 Pro. This one is online from Steam. It's loading the Steam launcher, that's why. Why advertisement option over here? Full screen enable DirectX 12 600p. Lowest resolution, okay. Poco X3 Pro. Rise of the Tomb Raider. Shadow of the Tomb Raider, that one can be played, really playable on this window pawn. Haha. Windows pawn. This one Soviet installation. Okay. Actually I got Wait, what happened to my controller? Actually, I already finished this game, so the save state, I got a lot of save state because maybe some other day I want to test different save state for a different device. Refresh rate 120 Hz. Even the GPD Win 4 only 60 Hz refresh rate. Sometimes I reduce to 45 Hz to prolong the battery life. Around 14 FPS, 13 maybe. Maximum 30 plus. Using gyro, but actually this controller got gyro. Got already. Wish. To 20 at you. Poco X3 Pro can be played with this device, but So next, LG G8X. The time out, the time zone. Let me check the size of the okay, man. This one got the audio itself. See the steam open on too many devices. Setting are the same. Why the audio coming that way? This one direct active. GNX or BBPS? BBPS, sorry. Mistake. BBPS, that one, GNX. I think this one playing offline because no internet. No Wi-Fi. Because you need Wi-Fi. Problem with it, only Wi-Fi. After this, have to connect to the all right to test it on GRX bus. GRX same setting. Reduce it a bit. Let's see. Got a heck club. Oh, this one, the what? What happened? Direct X 12. The VPP are connecting to the local area network since it don't have the Wi-Fi. Wait, hey, hey. Lost connection, controller. What happened? Why it crash? One more try. Crash again. So the GSX, the driver not fully installed, because this morning I just reinstalled the Windows on this LG GSX. So next B50S. B50S have to connect to the local area network. Don't have Wi-Fi. That's maybe some other time we can fix the Wi-Fi, but at the moment that's the problem. So B50S now connecting to the internet, the X12. Same state. This is B50S.
Nothing I can do for him now.
Constantine is on his way down from the prison. We need to get this mess in order before he arrives. Hey, can anyone hear me? God damn it, we gotta get comms back up.
More or less the IPS, same as this GSX. Same as this Poco X3 Pro. Thank you.
Never seen anything like that. Crazy son of a bitch. Rushing three armed men with an axe?
I don't know how they managed to take one of them alive.
Who the hell are these people?
Initial recon said there was an old village up in these mountains. But they expected farmers. Thought they'd surrender. I think I heard something. I'll take a look.
I got them.
Only the FPS a bit low, but can be played. This Rise of Tomb Raider.
There's more of them arriving.
After this, I try to reinstall the DX12 on this GRX. Let's see if I can fix the DX12 loading problem. Let's see the Windows and help PC. Disable this gyro. Cool. Why this one setting also go? Setting also set at 720p. But the rest are high or medium, I'm not sure. What about already? Running at 12 watt. 10 watt just enough for this game. High. Except dynamic medium. It will start at the last checkpoint. See the loading, the FPS. Wow, crashing. VPTS crashing. When connect to internet, it crash Bandicoot. Thank you. when this one 20 30 FPS at high. At high 30. Actually this game you can use the motion control. Gyro the motion. Better for aiming. When you aim more accurate. When you plug in the power, then you can get 60 FPS. Hold on. Correct. It will get to 28 watt. See the graphic more or less. Now it's 60 at high, high setting. Right, no need to show furthermore. Let me fix the G attack. G-Attack after installing the DirectX 12. That's why the driver important, DirectX 11, DirectX 12. Oh, crash. Crap. Problem, press or cut. Display driver. Well, maybe some other time. Not this time. Well, that's it. Thank you for watching. Stay tuned for the next video.